Well, hello everybody. Welcome back to Elevation Kids Online. My name is Robin and I am so excited that you are here with us for week number 3 of our series all about the fruit of the Spirit. Now, the fruit of the Spirit is not fruit we can eat. No apples, no watermelon, no oranges here. The fruit of the Spirit is things like love, joy, peace, patience, kindness. When we follow Jesus, the Holy Spirit, He helps us become more like Jesus. And then we have the fruit of the Spirit. So let's see what fruit of the Spirit we're going to learn about today. Ready? Drum roll. Peace. Today's fruit of the Spirit is all about peace. Now we're going to learn more about peace through our Bible story called Peter Escapes from Prison. But first, let's jump up for some praise.
It's so simple, faith like a child. I give you an inch and you take me a mile. I feel the wind rush and the thunder roll. 2 feet on the water, only one way to go. Yeah. I don't gotta be afraid no more, no. Cause I know you up and through the storm. I'm more than just a talker.
Fantastic job, guys. One of the best ways that we can have peace is through the praise and worship of Jesus. It'll help us send our troubles up to Jesus and He will bring us back some peace. But today we are looking at the story of Peter when he escapes from prison. Now, the Bible is a special book that's God's book. And there are lots of stories in the Bible, but today we are looking especially at the story of Peter. And in this story, Peter, he was thrown into prison, he's thrown into jail for doing something that was good. Even though Peter was in a bad situation, he still felt peace in his heart. So put your thinking caps and your listening ears on and let's hear our Bible story.
Slapstick Theater. Peter escapes from prison. This is Peter.
Hey-o!
Who was one of Jesus' disciples.
Yep.
Peter told people about Jesus. There was a king named Herod who tried to stop anyone who tried to tell others about Jesus. He arrested Peter and took him to jail to be executed. While Peter was in prison, the people of the church prayed for him. The night before Peter was supposed to go to trial, he was sleeping. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord stood before him. The angel woke Peter up and said, "Quick, get up." The chains fell off Peter's wrists.
Whoa!
Then the angel told him to get up and get ready to go and to follow him. So Peter left the cell, but all the time he thought was happening wasn't real and that it was just a vision. They passed by the guards, and when they came to the iron gate, it opened for them on its own.
Wow! Awesome!
They were walking through the street when the angel suddenly left him.
Wait, what just happened?
Peter finally realized that this was all really happening and that God had sent an angel to save him from what King Herod and the Jewish leaders had planned to do to him.
Wow!
He went to the home of Mary, where many believers were together praying. When Peter knocked at the door, a servant girl came to answer.
Hey, let me in! Peter!
When she realized it was Peter, she was so excited that she ran inside to tell people instead of letting Peter in.
I'm so honored.
It's Peter!
The people inside thought the girl was wrong and said, "It must be Peter's angel." But Peter kept knocking. When the people finally opened the door, they were amazed. Peter told them about what happened and all about how God sent an angel to rescue him from prison.
Whoa, Peter was in prison even though he didn't deserve to be. But Peter, he still had peace in his heart. Jesus gives us the gift of peace when we believe in him. And peace is when Jesus helps us to be nice and calm, no matter what's happening around us. When we follow Jesus, the Holy Spirit works to make us more like Jesus. And when we start having the fruit of the Spirit, not actual fruit, remember, not the fruit we eat, the things like love, joy, peace, and patience, we become more like Jesus. And we know that because our Bible verse tells us. Now, who remembers? Our Bible verse has lots of fruit of the Spirit in there, and it's a little bit difficult to remember them all, but let's see how we go. Why don't you try and say it with me? But the Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our lives. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. 9 different fruits. That gets a little bit difficult to remember them all. I've got an idea. Why don't we jump up and let's sing a song all about the fruit of the Spirit and see if we can remember them.
Well, it's easy to get mad.
Great job, guys. Do you remember any of those fruits of the Spirit? The Bible verse that we looked at before, it tells us about the fruit of the Spirit so that we can have the fruit of the Spirit when we follow Jesus. But I think I need a little more help to understand how we can have peace, even when things are really bad things or crazy things are happening around us. Now, I heard that Bog and Grass, they've got their food truck out again today and they're going to have some fun adventures together. Remember last week, the pies? Oh no, the pies. But they still found joy. I wonder what's going to happen on their adventure today and how they're going to help us learn more about peace. Let's check it out.
Okay, one cherry pie. No, oh, I'm sorry, blueberry pie? I can't do this, we're close!
Hello? Anyone home?
No, we're closed, no one's here.
Gus?
No.
Gus, come on, I know you're in there.
Fine.
Hey, Gus. Are you doing all right?
No, I can't do this on my own. Bog left me to go get more fruit, and then he left me all alone, and then there was this big rush of people, and I can't do it!
Oh, Gus. That sounds like it was really stressful for you.
You're telling me.
Oh. Well, there's a fruit of the Spirit I think you could really use right now.
What is it? A banana? No, thanks. I don't have a good track record with bananas.
No, it's not a banana. The fruit of the Spirit isn't like the same kind of fruit that Bog uses to make his pies. When we follow Jesus, the Holy Spirit works to make us more like Jesus and gives us the fruit of the Spirit. It's things like love, joy, and peace.
Oh, that last one sounds nice. I could use some peace right now.
Yeah, and you can even have peace when things are stressful all around us.
Oh, yeah? Well, how? I thought I could only have peace when it's calm and quiet.
The peace that God gives us helps be calm no matter what's going on around us. So, the next time things are stressful in the truck, just take a deep breath and ask for God to help give you peace.
Okay, I guess I can try that.
Gus! Where are the customers?
I'm sorry, I just got overwhelmed and I sent everyone away!
What?
Remember, Gus, you can have peace even right now.
What are you talking about?
God gives me peace no matter what's going on around me.
Ugh, more fruit of the Spirit stuff?
Yes.
I'll tell you what. I'll go tell everybody to open up for business again.
Okay.
Oh, look at that. You already have one customer.
How can I help you? Okay, one apple pie coming up. No? I'm sorry, we don't carry birdseed pie.
No birdseed.
Oh, no, he's saying pineapple. You want a pineapple pie? No. Well, we can put all the fruits together in one pie. I think you really like that. Let's do that. Okay, let's go.
Flapperos.
Wow. Instead of just getting really upset when things were going wrong and he was a little bit stressed, Gus asked God to give him peace. The next time you're feeling a little bit stressed or crazy or angry or sad, take a deep breath and ask God to give you the peace too, just like Gus did. I'm gonna try that. Now this week, remember, we can ask God to help us to have peace anytime. Day, night, middle of the night, if you wake up and you're not sure how to go back to sleep and you need to feel a bit more peaceful, you can ask God. You can just say, God, please give me peace and help me go to sleep. Amen. As simple as that, God will help you. But why don't we pray together this morning? Dear Lord, I thank you for each and every child watching. I pray peace over their entire households this week, Lord. I pray peace over their hearts, Lord. I thank you that you have given us the fruit of the Spirit and that we can find peace in any situation. Thank you for helping each and every one of us to find peace, to ask for that peace whenever we need. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, we've learned a lot of different things about peace today, and you can keep learning more by jumping online and grabbing some of our activities and sitting down with your family and talking a little bit about how you can be peaceful when things are sad or angry, making you sad or angry around you. Now, I am off to go and find my own piece. I'm going to go do some of the craft as well. It looks super fun today. But I will see you next time. Bye.